Take a guess at how many subscribers Tim has now.
Like at least 5.
A bit higher.
Like at least 8?
2 hours later.
Like at least 32,396.
I give up. Spyro! 50,000!
How's Tim handling it?
Nervous breakdown? No, I never have nervous breakdowns.
Oh, he's fine, fine.
Hey, Subfuries. All 50,000 of you, 50,000. That number is still just astounding me. I mean, what did I even do to deserve this? The Subfury community has grown to be something that I could never have dreamed of. So thank you. After the Titan Wing video that I made last week, which by the way is the fastest growing video I have ever had, like 7,000 new people have come to join the Subfury community. So I say to you, welcome. The rules are simple. Be kind, be supportive, and as always, stay nerdy. I suppose the question on your mind is, what am I going to do to celebrate? And at first, my reaction to reaching 50,000 subscribers was,
why?
Because I had no plans in the works, and I know that I have resisted doing a live stream for a long time because I'm really used to doing scripted videos, but no more. It's finally going to happen. I am going to be doing a live stream Q&A / party type thing with myself, my beautiful girlfriend Laura, and a couple of others. Now listen up, because the live stream will be happening at 4 PM EST Saturday 18th. That's in America, 10 AM Sunday 19th New Zealand time, or 9 PM Saturday UK time. I really hope that I got all those times right. So leave your questions for myself, Laura, or anything else that you want us to talk about down in the comments below, and I'll pick some questions for us to answer. Oh, and a little hint, if you really want to make sure that your question gets answered on the live stream, then Patreon supporters for just like $2 a month do get Q&A priority. Onto the video! Dragons in the How to Train Your Dragon world are divided up into 7 classes: Strike, Sharp, Boulder, Stoker, Tracker, Tidal, and Mystery. And it's this last class, Mystery, that we'll be talking about today. Because the whole class is a little bit weird when you think about it. Each of the dragons in the other classes share relatively easy to define characteristics. You know, Boulder class dragons look like they're sort of made of rocks, Stoker class dragons can breathe really hot fire, and Strike class dragons are all fast and intelligent and extremely deadly. There are plenty of similarities between the dragons within the same class. I mean, when you look at a Gronkle, an Eruptodon, and a Catastrophic Quaken, it's not difficult to see the connection between them. But what even is the Mystery class? Actually, I wonder which dragon class Mishka would fit into.
All hail Mishka!
Dragons in the Mystery class include the Armor Wing, Bone Napper, Forever Wing, Flightmare, Buffalord, Deathsong, and many others. In fact, its symbol is one of my favorite dragons, the Changewing. And the Mystery class, like all of the others, does have an official description in saying that little is known about the Mystery class dragons because of how stealthy and sneaky they are. So supposedly the dragons in the Mystery class are defined by being stealthy and sneaky, which I suppose would work because of dragons like the Slithersong and the Changewing and the Bone Napper. But it doesn't really fit for dragons like the Deathsong, which look like a flying set of traffic lights, or the Buffalord, which couldn't hide for the sake of it. In fact, when I looked at the list of Mystery class dragons, I found that most dragons weren't really necessarily stealthy or sneaky. But something interesting did happen to the Mystery class a while ago. Prior to the first movie, believe it or not, there used to be another class of dragons, Fear class, because these ones were extra terrifying. Fear class dragons were defined as silent, sneaky, they turn up when you least expect them. Some of them even have multiple heads. The dragons that used to be in this class included the hideous Zippelbank, the Snaptrapper, and Cartoon Network did allude that the Flightmare was part of this class. But after the first movie, when the Vikings no longer feared dragons, they got rid of this class entirely because, well, Zippelbanks weren't exactly as terrifying as they used to be. And what they did is that they moved all of the Fear class dragons, which you'll remember were described as kind of stealthy and sneaky and turn up when you least expect them, into the Mystery class. On that basis, I wondered if the Mystery class dragons could be defined as particularly deadly and cunning, or could kill you in unexpected ways that the other classes wouldn't have been able to. I mean, they would definitely fit with dragons like the Flightmare. But just like their original description, it didn't really fit. No, the Mystery class, I concluded, may have included dragons that were stealthy and sneaky and could turn up when you least expect them, but it did not describe the Mystery class as a whole. So what is the Mystery class, I cry to Mishka? I think it's pretty simple. The Mystery class is simply full of dragons that Vikings don't really understand well enough to put them into any of the other classes yet.
But Tim, we know all about the hideous Zippleback. Why would it be in the Mystery class?
That's a fantastic question, Jack and the Flower Stalk. The thing is that I think this can be explained by the fact that the hideous Zippleback and the Snaptrapper don't really fit into any of the other classes. Stoker, Boulder, Tracker, Strike. No. They may understand hideous Zippleback's pretty well, but they don't exactly have any of the obvious traits that traditionally define the dragons in the other classes. Now, it is true that they could create a new class for dragons like the hideous Zippleback and the Snaptrapper, just like they created the new Tracker class, but this is probably unlikely. They only created the Tracker class when they found, like, five or so dragons that they could all put in it, that they could all define a group of dragons with this similar kind of trait. At the moment, there are only two dragons that are just like them, that share those sort of features, so they don't really have enough to make it into its own distinct class, because they don't really know what defines it as a distinct class. So until they find more dragons like the hideous Zippleback and the Snaptrapper, guess what they'll be? A mystery! So what is the one thing that all Mystery class dragons have in common? That we don't know enough about them to decide which class they should probably fit into. Rise of Berk states this clearly. Not much is known about these dragons, hence the Mystery class. And this is why I have made it my personal mission to start a new series on these dragons, to put them into classes, or at least discuss why they should or should not fit into these traditional classes that the Vikings have. But that's all from me. By the way, thank you so much to the 50 or so of you who have already bought official Subfury t-shirts, like this one. Isn't it cool? You can still get your own down at the link down in the description and hopefully in the comments down below. We've already raised like $500 to go towards A21 to stop slavery in the modern world, and also to WWF, the World Wildlife Fund, to help endangered species and save habitats. I am so proud of what we have done as a community, and I can tell you for sure, Mishka, Supreme Leader Mishka, is proud of us as well. And you can still go get a t-shirt of your own. I promise they're not going anywhere soon. It'll be great if you want to get it for Christmas. You'd be able to get it just in time. The link, as I said, is down in the description. And hopefully in the comments. So a few videos ago I asked which Hogwarts house you would be sorted into and which house you would sort me into. And I gotta say, the results were super awesome to read. We have Subfuries that are Gryffindors, Ravenclaws, Hufflepuffs and Slytherins, all with your own different strengths that you bring to this amazing community. Now as for your guesses about which house you would put me in, I gotta say, I was really impressed. So pretty much every single one of you agreed that I would either be a Hufflepuff or a Ravenclaw. And guess what? I'm kind of both. When I took the official Pottermore test, I was so close between Hufflepuff and Ravenclaw that the Sorting Hat actually allowed me to choose. What did I go with in the end? I picked Ravenclaw. I'm sorry, Hufflepuff, but I love the colors blue and silver, and I'm a bit of an addict when it comes to riddles. Don't judge me. My question for you today is not a question. Tell me about your pets, cats, dogs, demigorgons. Let me know down in the comments below. In the meantime, remember my live stream next weekend. I would love for you to join us for the Q&A. It's gonna be pretty exciting and kind of terrifying considering it's my first one I've ever done. And I would love for you to come follow me on Twitter, Wattpad, Facebook. If you can, support me on Patreon. That'll get you Q&A priority. And send me stuff you've made at the address and links in the description below. Stay nerdy, Subfuries, and I'll see you in the future.